testing thumb IP extension. You'll have your patient's hand in a neutral rotation, resting on a flat surface or table as shown here. First thing you'll have your patient do is extend their thumb upwards into extension as far as they can go, so towards the ceiling. There you are. Now, as she's here, I'm looking at this joint right here, the IP, seeing how much extension she has while extending her full thumbward, her full thumb upward. Okay, now let rest back down, Rachel. Now, if I'm going to get more specific at this joint, what I'm going to do is I'm going to stabilize the proximal phalanx, and I'm going to add resistance to the distal phalanx. So, Rachel, what I want you to do is kind of have your thumb a little bit in flexion for me. Okay, now I want you to extend it upwards and resist me. 3, 2, 1. Depending on the resist that she gives me, I will rate that as a 4 or a 5. If she cannot do it in full range of motion, then I will rate that as a 2. If there's minimal movement into extension, I will palpate the extensor pollicis longus, which can be palpated in two areas. One area will be just distal to the IP joint here. You palpate there, or you can palpate just right here behind the thumb to test for any movement whatsoever. If you feel movement, that is a 1, and if you do not feel movement, that is a 0.